Good morning, boys and girls. We are so happy you joined us for our very first video classroom. We are going to have a really fun and great day. Would you please join us for our morning prayer? Dear Jesus, please show me how to spend this day, sharing your love in every way. Help us to be kind to everyone, to play and laugh and have lots of fun. Shining your light and giving your grace, sharing your joy with a smile on my face. Now we are going to do our Good Morning Preschool Friends song. Good morning, preschool friends, how are you? Good morning, preschool friends, how are you? It's time to start our day, we will work and learn and play. Good morning, preschool friends, how are you? Good morning, Miss Julia.
Good morning, Miss Nancy.
Good morning, Miss Jean.
Good morning, Miss Nancy. Good morning, boys and girls.
Good morning, Miss Kelsey.
Good morning, Miss Nancy.
Good morning, Miss Carol.
Good morning. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning, boys and girls. We're
so happy.
Good morning,
kids. Good morning.
We missed you.
Let's stand for the pledge. Is everybody ready?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Have a seat. We're going to start with the wheels on the bus. Everybody have their seatbelt on. Good, get on it.
Get your wheels going.
Wheels on the bus go round and round, round and round, round and round. The wheels on the bus go round and round, all through the town. The people on the bus go up and down, up and down, up and down. The people on the bus go up and down, all through the town. The driver on the bus says, move on back, all through the town. The babies on the bus go, wham, 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 wham. The babies on the bus go, wham, 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 all through the town. The mommies on the bus go, shh, 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 shh. The mommies on the bus go, shh, 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 all through the town. The horn on the bus goes, beep, beep, beep. Beep, 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 beep. The horn on the bus goes beep, 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 all through the town, all through the town, all through the town.
Ooh, we're at school, ready for the calendar, Miss Carol.
Okay. Here we are. And first of all, let's sing the months of the year. Ready? Are we all ready? Here we go.
January, February, March, and April, May, June, July, and August, September, October, November, December. These are the months of the year.
Now, let's take a look what month we are in. We need to look for our frog who hops from month to month. Does anybody see the frog? Where's the frog, Miss Julia?
The frog is on March.
March. Yes, the frog is still in March. We're still in March. Okay, it's a good thing our calendar is updated. And it is the month of March. Now, let's see if we can figure out what day of the week it is. But let's sing our Days of the Week song. Days of the week, days of the week, days of the week, days of the week, days of the week. There's Sunday and there's Monday, there's Tuesday and there's Wednesday, there's Thursday and there's Friday, and then there's Saturday. Days of the week, days of the week, days of the week, days of the week, days of the week. All right, did anybody figure out what day it is? Well, I'll give you some clues. Yesterday was Tuesday. So Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. I guess we need another hopping frog, don't we? What day comes after Tuesday?
Wednesday.
Wednesday. And I'm going to write that. And what does Wednesday start with?
What?
W. W. And some of you at home, you're going to say, now when you write the word day after this, the word day can stay the whole time. All you have to do is erase the letters before day. But it's Wednesday. Then I put a comma. That doesn't mean to completely like stop, like, but it does mean to slow down. Wednesday. And what month did we say we're in?
March.
March. Miss Julia, are you our helper today?
I can be.
Oh, goody. Yesterday was March 17th. Can we count to 17? Let's count to 17. Ready? Then we can figure out what number comes afterwards.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17.
What comes next?
18.
Miss Julia, can you find an 18?
Miss Carol, 18's a teenager.
It's a teenager, and you know what? I'm going to play a little game. Let's see if we know the difference. What two numbers do we use to make the number 18, our teenager number?
A 1 and an 8.
Okay, does it matter which order? Say if I were to put the 8 in front.
Oh, no.
Would that matter?
Yeah,
it would matter.
Oh, it would matter, wouldn't it? Because now it is no longer 18. It is 81. And we don't even have a month with that many days. So I'm going to erase that. So we know it's going to be Wednesday, March the 18th. I'll put another comma. And does anybody remember our year? Yes, Miss Nancy.
2020.
When will it stop being 2020? Do you remember? We have to go all the way to when?
December.
The last day in December, and then 2020? We'll be over. But so we'll be having 2020 still for a long, long time, won't we? We'll be in that year for a long time. Okay. Let's practice counting. And let's count backwards.
All right.
Count backwards from 10. Ready?
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. 4, 3, 2, 1.
What would be here?
Zero.
Blast off.
I need to find what day of the week it is.
Yes, you do. Calendar. Thank you for reminding me.
Julia, there's a pattern up there.
I have to find it.
Oh, and there is a pattern.
Thank
you, Miss Julia. You know, that's why I have a helper to remind me of stuff.
Should we do the pattern first?
Sure.
I have two shapes, a heart and a clover, and we have to figure out which one comes here.
Okay, so it's an AB pattern then?
We'll see. I don't think so.
It's not an AB pattern.
Do you want to leave us with the pattern?
A, B. Oh, I can't say A again, can I? That's another B. That's another heart. A, B, B. A, B, B. A, B, B. A, B, B. A, B, B, A, B. What comes next?
B. So another heart. Is this correct?
Yes, ma'am.
One
and
an 18?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank
you.
Okay, 18.
I am so happy you did that.
You are welcome.
Okay. Alrighty. So, everyone, we are going to be singing the ITZY.
To do the alphabet.
Go for the alphabet.
Right.
We're singing.
Let's get focused.
There we go. Okay.
Wait,
Boys and girls, you are so good at this song. Will you sing it with me?
Georgia, the state of Georgia can make the J sound too.
Yes, we our G can also make the J sound. You're right. Very good, Miss Carol. We have some letters like that that can, two letters can make the same sound, like K and C can make the K sound. Very good. Let's do one more since, oh, let's go to, I'm going to make the sound. What letter makes the sound? Do you know? Miss Julia?
M.
Very good. Very good. Well, boys and girls, you did an excellent job. Now, are you ready for Itsy Bitsy Spider? Miss Julia, do you want to come up and do Itsy Bitsy for us?
Can
I
do it with me?
Sure. Get your little spider.
Itsy Bitsy Spider went up the water spout. Down came the rain and washed the spider out. Out came the sun and dried up all the rain. And the Itsy Bitsy Spider went up the spout again.
Now here comes the big gorilla.
The big fat gorilla went up the water spout.
Down came the rain and washed the gorilla out.
Out came the sun and dried up all the rain.
Very good.
Thank you.
Now we're going to take a short pause so you can go get a snack. Welcome back. We're going to do Jesus Loves Me. Testament. That's right, 39. And in the New Testament, 27. Oh, you all are so smart. Let's go through the Old Testament and then we'll do the first four books of the New Testament. Are you ready? Let me get this open. Okay. Let's start with the Old Testament. Ready?
Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, Joshua, Judges, Ruth, 1st and 2nd Samuel, 1st and 2nd Kings, 1st and 2nd Chronicles, Ezra, Nehemiah, Esther, Job, Psalms, Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, Song of Songs, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel, Daniel, Hosea, Joel, Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, Nahum, Habakkuk, Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, Malachi.
Oh, that was wonderful, boys and girls. Let's do, I know some of you can do more than the first four of the New Testament, but let's just start with the New Testament. With Matthew, Mark, Luke, John. Very good. Now let's do our Bible verse, John 3:16. Are you ready?
For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. John 3:16.
Now at this time, Miss Kelsey is going to do the fruit of the Spirit.
Good morning, boys and girls. I'm so excited to do fruit of the Spirit with you this morning. Are we ready? Stand up.
Thank you.
coconut. Fruit of the spirit's not a coconut. You wanna be a coconut? You might as well hear it. You can't be a fruit of the spirit, cause the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control.
And in the Bible, they call him a publican, which means he was a tax collector. So when I read my story, I'm going to call him a tax man because I think most of you guys understand that better. But if I accidentally say publican, you'll just have to forgive me. All right, so we're going to start our story about Zacchaeus. Zacchaeus was a tax man. He served an evil king, collecting gold and silver to pay for everything, like soldiers, roads, and city walls, and statues carved from stone. Some publicans took extra gold and kept it for their own. Most people disliked publicans. They said, they're mean, they cheat. And so good people turned away whenever they would meet the tax collectors around the town or walking down the street. When Jesus met a tax man, he smiled and greeted him. He didn't care what others thought or if they acted grim. He loved all kinds of people. He was friendly with the mean, the selfish and the sickly, and those who were not clean. He knew so many couldn't choose the sort of life they had, and many others didn't know that they were being bad. And even if they knew inside, it made his heart feel sad. Zacchaeus once was going home when there along the way, he saw a crowd and curious, he thought he'd rather stay. You say this man is Jesus? May I get near to see? I want to know what he is like. But, ow, you're trampling me.
Remember, Zacchaeus was little.
"Please tell me what this huddle and this muddle is about." He begged and teased and pushed and squeezed and then began to shout, "I'm chief collector for the king. How dare you leave me out?" Zacchaeus ran and climbed a tree. He wished he weren't so small. But Jesus saw him there and stopped. Zacchaeus heard him call, "Come down, Zacchaeus, right away, and take me home with you." The people stared with angry looks, and some began to stew. They muttered, "What a place to pick, the home of such a fake. Don't tell us Jesus doesn't know. He does, for goodness sakes. It is a mystery to us, the friends Jesus likes to make." Zacchaeus climbed down happy with a sparkle in his eyes. He shivered from excitement. He felt a bigger size. It made him feel so popular. A messenger soon ran ahead to tell the news of this to all Zacchaeus's clan. A feast they started to prepare. The servants roasted meat. When Jesus got there later on, one washed his dusty feet. Another brought a lovely robe. Then it was time to eat. It took a while to eat such food. They sat and talked, and when Zacchaeus saw how Jesus' love could change the hearts of men, he said to Jesus, "I don't think of anyone but me. The extra money that I take, it's very plain to see, makes others poor. And here I sit, as wealthy as a king. Before another day goes by, I'll do an honest thing. My clothes and food and all I own, I shall divide in two. I'll take half to the poorer folk, and I know what I'll do. What I owe to any man, I'll multiply by four. I'll start to pay my debts today, and I will cheat no more." When Jesus rose to leave, he said, "I've had a splendid stay. Zacchaeus, it does give me joy to know you feel this way. And you will find that this has been a very special day." So we learned from our story about Zacchaeus today that sometimes people can do the wrong thing, but Jesus still loves all of us and he forgives us and takes away our sin. All right, you guys did such a good job of listening. Now it's time for us to take another preschool pause. And this time, oh, I'm sorry, we're not gonna pause right now. I'm so glad there's other people here to remind me what we're doing. We're gonna actually sing the song about Zacchaeus since we just heard about him. And then afterwards, we'll take our preschool pause.
It's gonna take a minute to load, apparently.
I'll tell you guys now while we're waiting for the song to load. When we take our preschool pause, you all need to make sure you have your folder or that you go get it. Some of you will have green folders, some of you will have yellow, some of you will have purple folders. So make sure that you get a grown-up to help you get your folder so you're ready for the next part of our day.
To your house today, Zacchaeus.
job. All right, now we get to take our preschool pause. Don't forget to go get your folders.
Hi, boys and girls. We're going to do just a couple of our stretches today, and we're going to do our legs. First, reach as high as you can and try not to bend your knees. Lock your knees and touch your toes. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now, like you're going to do a jumping jack, but we're not. And reach up again. And I'm doing my left one. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Now your other leg. 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. And those are the stretches we're going to do today. And that's all.
Boys and girls, I have a special activity you can do this afternoon after the video. It's in your special preschool learning activities folder. If you've not picked yours up at the preschool, please stop by and get your activity folder either today or tomorrow. Inside, you'll find lots of fun activities. One of the activities is called My Journal. And it has many things you can do in it. You can draw pictures and write about it. The first one that we'd love for you to do today, it says, where is your favorite place to go? And tell about it. So you're going to draw a picture of somewhere you'd like to go. Maybe you went to Disney World, or maybe you went to your grandpa and grandma's. We'd like you to draw a picture and then have one of your grown-ups that is with you help you write a sentence about your favorite place. Miss Julia did one for us, an example, and she'll show you what her favorite place is.
The one I drew, I put, my favorite place is Sweden because the cities are old, the forest is beautiful, and there is a midnight sun. The sun is up all the time, sometimes of the year.
Now, when you get finished drawing your picture and writing your sentence or having your grown-up write the sentence, would you please take a picture of it and send it to our email address at the preschool so we can put it on the webpage? Thank you.
Hi, boys and girls. Our theme this week is all about spring. Did you know that this week is the beginning of spring? That by the end of the week, it will be spring. It won't be winter anymore. And we have been talking about all the different things that show us that spring is here, that spring is coming. Can anybody tell me something that they have noticed about our changing season to spring?
Birds outside the windows. I see one right now.
Oh, there's a cardinal on the windowsill.
Oh, we have birds. Oh. We have our bird feeder. Oh. And you're going to have so much fun watching those birds during spring. Can anyone tell me something else?
There's leaves coming out on the trees.
The green leaves are coming out on the trees. And the flowers. What about the weather? What do we know about spring weather? That's right. Sometimes it can be very unpredictable. It starts out in wintry in March, and then by the end of the month of March, it's very, very gentle usually because we're in spring, but a lot of wind blows in March. March is one of the windiest, if not the windiest, month of the year, and that's why we are going to make your kites today. And then you will pick out a day that is very, very windy, and you will have fun running around outside with your kite. And we want you to be ready. This story is called The Wind Blew. It's written, the author's name is Pat Hutchins. And it's one of those stories. We've talked about how when we read that we can sometimes figure out what the story is telling us by looking at the pictures. And this book will help us predict things too if we know where to look. Here's our title page, The Wind Blew. Another title page, The Wind Blew. When we have several title pages, sometimes they'll have different pictures. The neat thing about wind is, can you see wind?
No.
No? But how do you know it's coming when it's windy? It causes things to move. Look at these trees. The wind blew. So what do you think the wind might be blowing here? Let's look at the illustrations and let's see if we can figure this out. What could the wind be blowing here? I see several things the wind could blow just in these illustrations. I see an umbrella. Oh, and I see a little girl playing with a balloon. This will be very interesting to see what all gets blown away. It took the umbrella from Mr. White and quickly turned it inside out. Oh, and it snatched the balloon from little Priscilla and swept it up to join the umbrella. Oh, do we see what might get swept away next? What might be blown away by the wind next? I see a wedding here. I wonder what might get blown away next. Let's turn the page and find out. And not content, it took a hat, and still not satisfied with that, so it took the groom's hat. Look at that. Oh, what do you think it's going to take next? Oh, those look like what we're making today, don't they, Miss Julia?
In our craft.
It whipped a kite into the air and kept it spinning round up there. Oh, I see a lady out here hanging her clothes up. What do you think the wind might grab next?
It's not going to be good, I don't think.
It grabbed a shirt left out to dry and tossed it upward into the sky. Wind can cause a big mess, but we like wind. It's enjoyable. It's fun. It plucked a hanky, from a nose. And up and up and up it rose. I forgot about that part since I read this last year, boys and girls. It lifted the wig from the judge's hair and didn't drop it back. Instead, I wonder what happened. Oh, it whirled the postman's letters up as if it hadn't done enough. Look at all that fun stuff flying around in the air. Maybe it wasn't fun for somebody. It blew so hard it quickly stole a striped flag fluttering on a pole. It pulled the new scarves from the twins and tossed them to the other things. It set the newspapers fluttering round, then tired of the things it found. What happens if the wind gets bored?
Let's turn the page and see.
It mixed them up. Throw them down. That's what happens when the wind gets bored. And it just all blew away to sea. What a wonderful ending. And now I'm just very excited that Miss Julia is going to show you our craft today that you get to make at home. And remember, if it's not really windy today, chances are it will be windy one day soon, and you'll get to run all around that yard and fly your kite. Thank you so much for listening to the story.
Hey, everybody. Now get your preschool learning activity folder and open it up, and you have your craft side, and you'll find a kite in there. I don't know which color you have, and a baggie with sequins and your balloon string. And you have crayons we provided, but you can use anything else you would like at home. And we're going to decorate our kite. And I won't do too much, but I'll do a quick one so you can understand. I can't wait to see what you guys come up with. Alright, and you're going to need glue. You may have to get your parent to help you with this to glue your sequins down. I'm going to start with this one, all red sequins. I hope it's windy tomorrow. Oh, thank you. I hope it's windy tomorrow so we can play with it next time we're here to show you. And pretend I covered this with sequins. You can do as many or as little as you like. And afterwards, you're going to need the grown-up to help you tie this on. And you will have your kite.
So pretty.
Thank you.
Pretty. It's pretty.
And we're going to close out with the Lord's Prayer. So fold your hands, close your eyes, and bow your head. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you, and we can't wait to see you tomorrow.
We'll see you tomorrow.
Bye, guys. Bye.
We love you.
We miss you.
See you tomorrow.